The topic itself is very interesting, that is failing economy and falling rupee. I thought this was a self-creation of this government right from 2007 onwards, because some of the figures which Mr. Srikanth Reddy has shown just now, the year in which we were born, that is I and Srinivas was in 61 and I was born in 60, rupee against dollar was only 4 rupees 77 paisa. Today it is at 60, and the joke in stock market circles in last couple of days was rupee has become a senior citizen. And truly it is staying above 60 for these last 2 days. And among the statistics which Mr. Srikanth Reddy has shown, if you see, the sharpest depreciation of rupee has taken place in fact between 1990 to 2000. From 17 rupees 50 paisa, it has fallen all the way to 44 rupees 50 paisa. Why it should have happened? Because the economy, the liberalization process, in fact, was started in 91. Then if economy was supposed to have grown rapidly from 91-92 onwards, why did our rupee not strengthen itself or fall lesser than any other currency against dollar? That means something was wrong in the reforms that we are not willing to accept. Before coming to that again, rupee has fallen to 60 rupees from 2007 October when it was 39. It was strongest in 2007 October, as early as in 2007. In 2000, it was 44 rupees 50 paisa. That means, in fact, rupee strengthened itself by 2007 October to 39. From 39, the depreciation is as high as more than 50% in this just 5 years. That is, the depreciation has started more rapidly from UPA 2. It's not from UPA 1, from 2004 to 2007. Then what could have triggered this depreciation from 2007 onwards? I have my own interesting hypothesis. Today everybody in, say, in Bengal or in many other states, in our own state also, people are interested in catching thieves who go by money circulation schemes, Ponzi schemes and all these things. We have seen in Bengal also, Sharda followed, and even in Andhra Pradesh also. What I felt was, from 2007 onwards, Indian government itself was running a big Ponzi scheme. Why, I'll tell you. Whenever money was necessary, disinvestment was done. Valuable PSU stock or whatever was done, sold at throwaway prices. Large tax breaks were given, with incentives like SEZs, whatever it is, which in fact have not increased the revenue, have curtailed the revenue of the government, and you throw freebies for social sectors. And it was a jobless growth, which was highlighted by the government. See the figures of unemployment, how much the unemployment has been generated post 2008. It's practically nothing to boast of. When the government itself has triggered this sort of negligence or whatever it is, policy paralysis, whatever you name it, I have 10 reasons to show why the economy is failing today. Growth of crony capitalism, whatever it is. There are many reasons, including corruption, whatever it is. But the main thing is, government has not taken care of the economy as it should have done from 2007 onwards. Because the whole regime was changing. From rule-based regime, we were changing to right-based. We had Right to Information Act. We are having Right to Education. Today, Right to Food. When the whole regime is changing, your economy also should have been transformed in a similar manner. And I'll tell you one thing. The reforms were started from 91. And today, if you go by the population statistics, 40% of the population today was not even born in 91. We have such a youthful population today. We keep on hyping, we have the big demographic dividend, having such a youthful labor. But what are we doing with this demographic dividend? Without creating jobs for them, it's a sheer waste. No need to hype at all. And every year 1.2 crores labor is getting added to the system. The advantage with us against China is every year 30 lakh people are retiring in China. We should take advantage of that at least in the next 1-2 decades by creating jobs which will flow out from China to India.